time. Are you ready?
Yes, I guess. It's louder than I expected.
You've never been so close before.
I guess everything's bigger up close.
Soon it'll all seem familiar. Like home.
I don't know about that.
Look for High Matriarch Tirsa. She'll help you. Any other concerns?
What should I expect once I'm inside?
There'll be people celebrating and feasting. More than you've ever seen in one place. No other village compares to Mother's Heart. It is the seat of the High Matriarchs. A center of Nora life. A jewel of the sacred land. Give it time, and you'll grow fond of it. As I was. Back when I was at the tribe.
Are you sure they're gonna let me in?
I've told you, Aloy. By law, any child outcast can run in the proving.
And any who pass are made braves and are outcasts no more. I know that. But not everyone follows the law like you do, Rost.
Have faith, Aloy. The tribe will honor your right.
Any final lessons before I head in?
No. You've learned every lesson the wilds have to teach.
It was you who taught me, not the wilds. Not sure my bow and spear will be much help in there, though.
It is with bow and spear that you'll win what you've wanted all these years, Aloy. Answers.
I'm ready to do this. See you back home in a few days?
You will not find me there, Aloy. Here. Take this to... remember.
Why are you talking like we'll never see each other again? No. No!
You should be with the tribe. And I will always be an outcast.
But I told you, I have that figured out. I'll come to you in secret. I'll be the one breaking the law, not you. You don't even have to talk to me.
This attachment to me will only hold you back. It's my wish that you embrace the tribe. You've lived in isolation long enough.
Not until now, I didn't.
For your sake, I must go where you will never find me. This is goodbye.
No, it's not. You taught me how to track. Wherever you go, I can follow.
Not this time.
This time. And every time. I'll be wearing this when I find you.
May Allmother bless you, Aloy.
And you. I have to let him go. For now. First, the proving. After that, I'll see where his trail leads.
You will turn back, outcast. Or bleed. Your choice.
Make way! Make way! Braves, stand aside. She is welcome here. Mother's heart is open to you, child. Come. I assure you, most Nora aren't so rude as those idiots.
You're Tirsa?
Who else would I be? Come on now. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
You have?
Oh, yes. But for the moment, I must leave you. I have other outsiders to keep safe tonight.
You what?
Envoys from another tribe, the Karja, come to observe the proving, and oh, how the Nora hate the Karja.
Carja.
But that's my problem. We will talk later. In the meantime, enjoy the festival. Oh, down the path to the right, you'll find an old friend who can't wait to see you.
But I don't know anyone here.
Try telling him that. We will talk later. May the goddess protect.
What is going on?
Isn't it? Over here. It is Aloy, isn't it? I'm remembering your name correctly.
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hope to see you again, if you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I served the tribe as a stitcher instead, a maker of garments and armor. In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you. I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Cost? Nothing. Consider it the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue. Seems to fit you perfectly.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing. Every outfit offers some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's Lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside.
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Carja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
Oh, no.
job. Nice. Hot as a forest fire.
Jog! Get down from there! Bad enough you're drunk. Why do you have to go climbing houses?
Oh, not supposed to go climbing on other people's roofs, huh?
Get down from there, now!
Oh, that's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
What I want is for you to climb down!
What you want is for me to have no fun at all!
Now, for you'll have to tell this when I'm gone. In the beginning, all life came from All Mother. People, machines, and beasts, all were her children. They lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some grew restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These were the Faithless. The machines had whispered to them, promised to serve them, to make them a new world, better than the one All Mother provided, a world of metal. They told the Faithless they would do all the work for them, feed them, shelter them, give them a life of ease, of plenty.
It's better than last year.
So, the Faithless left with the machines. Only the true children, the mothers and fathers of the Nora, stayed with All Mother. At first, the machines did as they had promised.
Aloy, over here!
Karst? What are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow. Can't wait to see the looks in some of these faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
So, Mother's Heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, a man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
You can't be.
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me. All sails are final. If it breaks, you're out of luck.
Then, time to go.
Good luck tomorrow, Aloy.
In a moment, we shall bless the proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
Peace. It's peace.
An annunciation of gratitude written Killers by and the slavers. Hand of yeah. Sun King of
Killers and slavers!
Hey, hey!
Luminance!
Hold your fruit, Nora Faithful. Hold your fruit. Now, I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. He was. He was a tyrant and a monster. He raided my tribe for blood sacrifice, just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja. But the 13th King is dead. 2 years now. And who killed him? The 14th.
Yeah.
Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah! Yeah.
The message that this poor priest means to read is an apology. Straight from the lips of the 14th King. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
Thank you. An enunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th Luminance of the Radiant Line.
I won't let the Karja faithful stop me from it. On
the best of you.
What harm can we do now?
No, he's wearing a focus, just like mine.
As the sun's light frames the stoutest tree.
Where did he find a focus? You're the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. If you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
What's wrong?
Apologies. A malfunction.
Olin, you making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No, we'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. Well, I guess he's more hungover than I thought. Hey, you got the same trinket that Olin has on his head. Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. He spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half
drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense. It looks great on you.
I've never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Well, let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard of the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one. You might even give a Nora Warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
With all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
What else do you know about Olin?
Is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
I thought your friend was gonna go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids, and who can blame them?
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
I never heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was in war and you didn't even know? Were you kept hidden away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me. But even an outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year? Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work. But for years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
So, what happened? How did it all end?
The Mad King's own son united Karja rebels with Oseram freebooters. And together we did the impossible, took back Meridian and killed the crazy old king. So now the son sits on the throne and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
Your sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, yes. Sacrificed, no. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain. Captain of the entire Vanguard, favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she survive?
Well, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three? Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
You said the machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah. I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh. I'm sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. If that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
Tell me about the derangement again.
Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. If that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
I should make my way to the Blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but it's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater. I mean, you're smart. You're obviously capable, and, well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
You know what. All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'll be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that Blessing thing, too, so, see you around, maybe?
Start the Blessing when all aspirants are in place. Aloy, take your place right there. The prayer lantern is yours. I made it for you. Blasphemy.
Sisters.
Aspirants! Before each of you sits a prayer lantern crafted by your mother. In her honor, light its flame.
In honor of Rost, and all he did to help me get here.
Mother, hear our prayer. What is the child but a mother's hope that takes flight? A glowing flame that climbs the air, set free to the wind, sailing the sky till it fades and falls. So, from one to another, passes the chain of love.
There's Olin. I have some questions for him.
I heard he'll ask for a mate blessing if he wins, but not with his girl, but with his sister. Imagine.
The Karja have come to make amends.
Hello,
You know my name? Ah, guess Aaron told you.
Why did you act so strange when we spoke earlier?
Must be this festival. I'm really not one for crowds. Maybe I should just turn in.
Stop dodging my questions.
All right, cool your fire. I got nothing to hide.
I've never seen anyone else with a focus. Where exactly did you find it?
In a ruin, north of the Claim. That's our name for the Aseram homeland. Up there, the metal seams run deep. Steel giants half buried in loose soil. Forgotten caves that the old ones bored into mountain rock. Your eyes just lit up.
I found my focus in a cave just like you're describing. A ruin of the old ones.
If you've delved yourself, you know as much as I do. Go to those places for answers. Not me.
When we spoke earlier, you winced, then looked like you were in pain. Or frightened. Did your focus show you something?
It didn't show me anything. I told you. It malfunctioned. Happens all the time.
Mine's never malfunctioned, and I've had it since I was a child.
So yours is in better shape, then. I'm sure the land here is full of relics. Seeing how you Nora are too scared to delve the ruins.
Because they think ruins are cursed. But I never said I think that.
If the North acknowledges a curse, I'm inclined to agree.
What are you doing here, Olin? Why come to Noraland?
Aaron needed a scout for his expedition, and a second for his drinking, that's all. Someone to stop the Sun Priest getting lost. When all this is over, I'm back to delving ruins, rummaging for scrap, scrounging up trinkets to sell.
So you're an explorer?
Just another outlander, girl. A man's gotta make his shards. I just make mine in service to the King's court, that's all.
I don't understand. We have this device in common, but you can't wait to stop talking to me.
I already have all the friends I need, girl. I don't need to bother.
I'm used to being shunned by the tribe. I thought you'd be different.
It's nothing personal. It really isn't. You should try to enjoy yourself tonight. Big day tomorrow. Always best to make every day count.
I heard he'll ask for a mate less if he wins, but not with his girl.
Nah, this just doesn't compare to 5 years ago. The entertainment.
Find your bed, outcast, and dream of winning the proving. That's the closest you're gonna get.
Oh, this is the bedhouse? With you standing guard, I figured it was the latrine.
You're very present here!
Well, well. Look who's come in from the wild. The motherless outcast. I see you've still got a scar from where that rock I threw hit you. Now that's a cherished memory.
You can be a real lard sometimes, boss. Cut it out.
Where's your bite, outcast? Or did you need my permission to speak in the presence of a true Noral? We saw you talking with the outsiders. Couldn't convince them to take you either, huh? You didn't know the word. Aw, you even tried to dress like a real Nora. Not that it fools anyone.
So this is how it's gonna be with you, is it?
This is how it's gonna be with everyone, outcast. You belong in the wilds, not Mother's heart. and you definitely don't belong in the Proving.
You can sense it. You already know you're gonna lose.
I've trained all my life for the Proving. I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of anything.
Really? Confidence is quiet. You're not.
You know, I often think of the day I gave you that scar. It's a cherished memory.
Yeah. The look on your face when I knocked that stone out of your hand was pretty entertaining. But I suppose you leave that part of the story out when you tell it, don't you?
I branded you that day to mark your shame.
All you did that day was make me stronger. Just wait. I'll show you tomorrow.
Yeah, right. This is boring. Time for Boss to get some sleep. You'll be the one surprised tomorrow, Outcast. Not me.
Oh, are you gonna shut your mouth? Because that would be a surprise.
Nice job handling Bost. That should keep him quiet. Till morning, anyway.
I don't believe we've met. I'm Aloy.
Oh, I know who you are. The competition. The others, they'll finish the Proving. Most of them. But win it? That's down to Bost, you, or me. Vala.
Nice to meet you, Vala. You're right. I am going to win tomorrow.
Never celebrate a victory before it's earned, girl. My mother taught me that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna get some sleep. I plan to be well-rested when I run you into the ground tomorrow. Your bunk's right there when you want it.
Okay. Thanks.
So, your first day in Mother's heart. What do you think? You've never slept in a Nora Lodge before. Not very private.
It has certain charms.
Homey enough, once you're accepted.
That's the problem.
I think you'll find a place here. I do. Get some rest.
Yourselves.
What will it take to get you out of here?
Razor!
Your trophy is shattered, Outcast. Looks like you'll need another.
Dead last, girl. Might as well walk from here. Boss will win, or Vala. But you'll be made a brave so long as you finish. Oh, now. That's an old trail. Two died on it last year. It's falling apart. Better dead last than dead altogether. Whoa, 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 whoa! My old mother, are you crazy? You're gonna kill yourself! It doesn't get any easier! You're insane to go that way!
That's it. No way but forward
just
now!
Stop right there!
Where's Malik?
I can't see! Boss, go follow right back. Come on now! Faster! Stop dragging! Gotta keep going.
The outcast. On the other trail?
Is she crazy?
Good. I'm gaining.
The outcast is catching up.
How'd she get up there?
An outcast? Win the proving? Never. For she is a brave now.
You did it.
As are you all. So long as you put your trophy on the altar. But it is Aloy. Once outcast, and now brave. Who is first among you?
make it under fire.
They can't shoot if they're dead. Keep them busy. I'll find an angle.
Bass! Bass! Are you with us?
I'm with you!
Let's go. Now!
Too many of them! We can't win!
Kill them all! No witnesses, no survivors!
Stay together!
Oh no! There's more! They keep coming! How many are there?
There's more of them.
Too many of them!
Descend while we have a chance.
Get back!
Ah! Bala!
Bala! No! Wow!
The red hair dies now! Everyone! Forward!
Burn it all, then to your task.
As you command.
Is dying.
Caretaker, there is blasphemy.
She should be near her mother.
They must have found me before I bled out. But why is no one here? Where am I? I need to find my focus. My clothes. Good. But where's my focus? Patriarchs are allowed inside. I don't see my bow here. Or that damaged focus, the one I took off that killer. Where are they? I'm picking up some kind of signal. Like the ruins I fell into when I was young.
Venora didn't build this place. The old ones did. But why? Some kind of power cell. I wonder what it's for. There. With the rest of my things. It must be the damaged focus. The one I took from that killer. It's close.
Excavations and proceed at once to the mission point. Avoid all contact with Nora savages, but if you are seen, kill every witness. Target imaging attached. Do not fail.
You are awake.
You brought me here?
Quickly, you must follow.
To where?
To the place where you were born.
Are you saying I was born here? Inside the mountain?
It is easier if I show you. To die near one's mother is sacred. Lantra fought it, of course, but Jezza sided with me.
Is my mother here? Am I going to meet her?
It's complicated. Please, just follow me.
Does my mother look like me? But with short hair.
I don't see how that could be. You were not born of a woman, Aloy. The mountain is your mother.
What are you talking about?
Come.
is this place?
The Great Chamber, where All Mother slew the Metal Devil and gave birth to you. Aloy, the Proving Massacre was just the first of many disasters. The war party we sent after the killers was ambushed and slaughtered.
But what does that have to do with where I was born?
My hope is... everything. This is where we found you. We heard your cries, came to look, and there you were.
Just lying there?
Yes.
You mean I came from behind the door?
Always, that is what I have believed. That you came from the womb of the mountain. A gift from All Mother herself. But others, like Lansra, feared that a darker power put you here. Not a gift, but a curse.
But... this isn't a goddess.
Aloy!
It's a door. With people behind it. My mother?
Oh!
Hold for identiscan.
The goddess speaks.
Just like the woman I saw.
Error. Alpha registry corrupted. Identity cannot be confirmed. Entry denied.
No. No.
Aloy, All Mother spoke to you, as if she knew you.
Were you not listening? It didn't recognize me.
Because of corruption, the goddess's own words. Surely, if you heal this corruption, she will see you clearly.
And how would I do that?
You said you've had visions. Of a woman with short hair.
The killers came for me. Because I look like her.
But their power is overwhelming. Is there no other trail to follow?
Olin. He was one of the outsiders. The night before the proving. The killer saw me through his eyes. He lives in Meridian.
So you will have to leave the sacred land.
I've been an outcast all my life. Why not an exile too?
There is another way. Come, and we will make it so.
You said the tribe was on the brink of extinction. What happened?
After the massacre at the Proving, a great war party was sent after the killers. Less than half survived.
How was the war party defeated?
The killers do not fight alone. Somehow they have a power over the machines, corrupting them, driving them mad.
So the killers got away?
Yes. And now the only plan my sister matriarchs can agree to is to sing the Hymn of Atonement and beg for All Mother's mercy, as though she would not want us to help ourselves.
Then, what's your plan?
This. This was my plan. To show you where you were born and loose you to follow the destiny All Mother intended for you. The other High Matriarchs are waiting for us. Let me do the talking.
It is done?
Yes. I showed her. Sisters, the goddess spoke to Aloy, told her to heal the corruption.
Ha! But how is she to do that?
she will have to journey beyond our sacred land.
A seeker?
If the goddess spoke, it must be so.
You would name this thing a seeker?
Sister.
For once, Lansra, join with us.
This will be your sin, not mine. Send her seeking, and may she never be seen again.
Aloy, by the holy grace of the One Goddess, we hereby anoint you a seeker of the Nora tribe.
No barrier can now stay you from your sacred task. May All Mother protect you and sustain you. Stay true. I will make ready for the hymn. Our hopes lie with you.
Tirsa, what's a seeker?
You are. And here is your mark. In times of great need, the High Matriarchs may anoint a seeker. A worthy brave sent forth to accomplish a great purpose. No matter where that purpose might take her.
Even beyond the borders of the Sacred Land?
Yes. And with the right to return when you are done, or as the need arises.
So, I can go anywhere at all. No restrictions.
Even to forbidden places, like the tainted lands beyond All Mother's sight, or the ruins of the Metal World.
I see. Have there been other seekers?
There have, but they are rare, and most who set out are never heard from again.
Was Rost a seeker?
No, not a seeker.
What are you not telling me?
This is not the time, Aloy. Perhaps another day.
I should be on my way.
From here, you must go to the Gates of the Embrace. Speak to Varl, and he will point the way to Meridian. If any Nora tries to stand in your way, Aloy, make sure they know you are a seeker.
Oh, I will. Thank you, Tirsa, for all you've done.
May All Mother bless you and watch over you.
Nora faithful, we will soon begin. Your hearts. Soon we will beg. For the sins that brought such misery on the tribe. When we hear the matriarchs lift their voices, we will join ours to theirs. The outcast girl. So she survived her wounds.
I need to keep my kit dry.
She saved many lives. The tribe is lucky to have her.
Thank you.
Need them soon enough.
Mother be praised. You're
I heard the rumors, but I didn't know for sure until I saw you just now. I'm glad to see you're okay. And you're even wearing the tunic I stitched for you. I'm honored.
I need the gate opened.
Do you have any idea how dangerous it is out there?
I need to pass through.
You'll have to talk to Resh then, up on the wall. He's the new war chief. I'm not sure he'll help you.
I should be on my way, Teb.
May all mother go with you.
The outcast approaches. Ignore her. Continue the report. There are rumors of a demon loose in the embrace. A thing of dark metal that corrupts every machine.
I need the gate opened.
Since when has any outcast's need been my concern?
Since I was anointed a seeker. Now open the gate.
You? A seeker? Have Tisser and Jezza gone insane? Bad enough that they let you run in the proving. But to nurse you back to health inside the sacred mountain? No wonder a curse is upon us and children lie dead under cairns of stone.
If you think Tirsa and Jezza are traitors, why don't you head up the mountain and say that to their faces? Or do you only talk big when your superiors aren't around?
I am the Nora War Chief.
And I am a seeker, so do as you're told and open the gate.
The sooner you're gone from here, the better.
What was that?
Thank you.
You made them obey you. But how? This. You did it with this. It's connecting to my focus. And I could use this. It's worth a shot. A couple loops of wire. Looks like it'll hold. I just need to test it.
Aloy! How did you do that? You killed that demon. Pulled its guts from the carcass.
The way it controls other machines. I think I've figured it out. But I need to test it on a machine.
Plenty of striders along the path to the gates of the Embrace, I guess.
Exactly. And the gates are where I'll be headed anyway. I need to speak to Varl.
I always knew you were different, Aloy, but...
But what?
I think you're a blessing from All-Mother. No matter what Resh says.
Thank you, Teb. But I have to go now.
I know you do. And my thoughts go with you.
Braves! I want that gate repaired immediately! I don't care if you have to bandage it together. Get it done!
I need to find a machine. Test this override device. Clear that up later. These. I can test the override device on them. Should go in quiet. Don't go through all of this to wind up trampled. Nice and quiet. Okay, here it goes! Come on, come on. It worked! It's not hostile. Seems almost tame. I think I could write it. There we go. That a boy. That's more. Yeah! 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 Ride! Strider is fast! This beats walking. I should try overriding other kinds of machines. Probably can't ride them all, but I might find a use for them.
Watch yourselves! Bring it closer! Closer!
High Matriarch Tirsa said you might know the way to Meridian.
The capital of the Karja Sundom? You seek exile?
No. A traitor named Olin. The Matriarchs made me a seeker so I could go after him.
Huh. Well, then you should head north to Mother's Crown. If you make it, talk to Maria. She'll point the way.
If I make it?
The trail is dangerous. Ever since the War Party massacre, our lands go unpatrolled, and our borders unguarded. We have no war chief to lead us.
Isn't that Resh's job?
Ugh. Only because Sona went missing. I'd go after her myself. But she ordered me to hold this gate with my life. And so I have.
You said the trail is dangerous. What sorts of dangers?
Almost too many to name. The killers are still out there, and somehow they've corrupted the machines, spreading madness.
Yes, I've seen it myself.
Bandits, too. Cutthroats who snuck across the border to prey on us. The word is, there's a camp in the metal ruins upriver.
Sounds like I need to craft more arrows. You said Warchief Sona is missing?
Even when the war party was massacred, she wouldn't give up the chase. She called for volunteers and went after the killers.
You didn't volunteer?
Of course I did. But Sona denied me that. She ordered me to see the wounded back to the Embrace. And to guard this gate. To guard the Embrace. With my life. That was days ago, and since then there's been no word from her.
So there's no way to know if she's alive or dead?
If anyone could survive out there, it would be her. Sona's prowess is legend. An unbending spear to measure ourselves against.
Sounds like she sets a high standard.
Oh, you have no idea. She's my mother.
I should be on my way.
Aloy! Before you make the journey to Mother's Crown and beyond, is there any chance you could search for Sona? The tribe needs her leadership. I'd go after her myself if she hadn't commanded me to hold this gate at all costs.
Where was she last seen?
The War Party massacre site, a wooded hollow across from Devil's Thirst on this side of the river. You might be able to pick up her trail there. She went after the killers who attacked the Proving. Who killed those we love, who tried to kill you.
I get it, Varl. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
May the goddess protect.
My whole life, all of it in the embrace. The world just got bigger. Are you all right, Hunter? Were you injured when the war party was ambushed?
Not exactly. And I'm not a hunter, or a brave, or anything really. You shouldn't even be talking to me.
Well, whoever you are, you're hurt. What happened?
My name's Kren. I thought I'd have a go at the trials at the hunting grounds over the rise, you know, hone my skills. It didn't go very well.
You got injured at a hunting grounds? How?
Well, I was aiming for a canister on the back of a grazer, and my bowstring snapped, and I tripped, and... forget it. It wasn't pretty, okay? I just wanted to train a bit. Hunting grounds are perfect for that. They offer trials, which are like challenges, and they give you marks if you accomplish objectives or beat certain times. The keeper's up there on the hill, just to the north. Talk to him to do a trial. I'm sure you'd be better than I did.
I need to get going, Kren.
All right. Be careful. Especially if you're heading north. And be sure to hit the hunting grounds if you want to train up.
Snow's got a bite out here. I spoke to Kren. He told me this is a hunting grounds where you offer tests of skill.
Poor Kren. Not the best hunter. But at least he keeps his chin up. You bear the mark of a seeker. I've heard of those, but never seen one. You have the matriarch's leave to come and go as you like from the sacred land?
Yes, but I would have gone even without their permission.
Is that so? Then maybe you and I can speak plainly. Truth is, I've had dealings with the Carja. I represent an organization called the Hunter's Lodge in Meridian. We test promising young hunters with trials at places like these. You might be just the kind of person we're looking for. Why don't you sample the trials and see? Just to be clear, though, I'd appreciate it if you kept our conversation in confidence, especially when it comes to the matriarchs. Which tools trial would you like to try? I'll explain how it works. Test your skill with bow and arrow by shooting parts off the backs of grazers as quickly as possible. Hope you enjoy it. I'll start timing when you slide down one of the ropes. You didn't pass. I'm sorry. I have a good feeling about your next run, though. Test your skill with bow and arrow. Perfect.
Thank you. Yes! I finally found someone who could earn this full sum. Test your skill with Bob. Can't wait to see what you do with that. Ready?
Shouldn't use my weapons up here. We'd be cheating. Being able to override you would help. Fascinating, if they weren't looking for me. Here they come.
Well done. I have had so little... Test your skill with bow and arrow by shooting parts off the backs of grazers as quickly as possible. I like that one. Slide down a rope and I'll start to... Here's your blazing sun. I'm ashamed to admit I've never won one myself. This trial tests your ability. Remember, you can use explosions from your blast sling to scare machines into fleeing where you want them to go. That's a good one. Timing begins once. Thank you.
does it.
How'd you... First time, and you win a blazing sun. You're good, even for Nora. This trial requires you to bring grazers down with blast wires. But you'll need the Karja Tripcaster and ammunition to do it. My friend here may have them for sale.
I have to go.
I'll be here if you decide to come back.
I'll save the shooting for down in the hunting ground.
Ready to try another? Use your... Can't wait to see what you do with... How'd you... First time, and you win a blazing sun. You're good, even for Nora. You have everything you need to enter the Hunter's Lodge. Good luck in Meridian. Of course, you can still run more trials with me.
Time for me to head out.
I'll be here when you're ready to test yourself.
My focus is picking up some kind of signal. Maybe I can scan it. That man. He doesn't look Nora. Okay, the signal's getting close. That signal... Where is it coming from?
There's danger ahead, girl.
Danger for you, Outlander. This is Noraland.
Yes, yes, yes. Trespass is forbidden on pain of death. Strange phrase, the pain of death. See? This one's in no pain at all.
Who was he?
A thief, slaver, a killer. The kind that give honest killers a bad name.
Farrell told me there would be bandit ambushes on the road.
Well, it's not all good news. They don't always come to you. Most dig out a camp, and there they'll sit like spoil on meat.
Unless someone does something about it?
I like you. Follow the trail of smoke on the other side of the ruins. I'll be there.
Those ruins. I have 3 sons. Now they'll let me inside the Hunter's Lodge. Well, let's see how that turns out. That for later. This must be where the war party got massacred. Such destruction. Lots of machines. All controlled by the Killer. Lenora managed to take down a corruptor. Maybe the War Chief left. They sent a stampede of them down the slope. But not before the Killers used it to send the other machines against them.
Brave! Let us speak!
The dead and wounded all cleared away. Are there no more Braves or healers here?
Just me. You're hurt. What happened?
I didn't. It's madness out there. War Chief Sona sent me back to report. I'm no good to her like this.
Varl told me that the War Chief tracked the Killers. Did she find them?
We followed their trail, but again and again they sent corrupted machines to attack us. My wounds started to slow me down, so the War Chief sent me back to let others know she hasn't given up the fight.
Varl sent me to look for Sona. Do you know where she is now?
All I can tell you is where we parted. Near the metal tower, southeast of the ruins at Devil's Thirst. Look to the rise behind it with a lone boulder. I'll head for the Embrace and report what I know to Varl and the others. May All-Mother lend you strength. You'll need it, going alone.
I can't override that machine. But if I could learn more about it...
Thank you.
Just stay out of their way for now. I'll find a use for you. Jumping onto the tonic. Okay, time to climb up to its head. Poked in the head either. It sends what it sees to other machines.